Hallelujah.
Listen to my problems, but what I think I need to hear, nice and loud and crystal clear, is about the one who's gonna solve them. Oh, I need something that can fill my soul. Something about that amazing grace sound of praise makes my troubles not seem so strong. Let me hear a heart set free. Holy Bible to a melody. Turn it up and then play it again.
How you doing out there? All the Hispanic Latinos. Shabbat Shalom. Amen. First time ever broadcasting live in the studio here, Passion for Truth. Want to say Shabbat Shalom to everyone out there. This is more of a test than anything. Let you guys know what God's doing in the background. We've been working along here hard. Wanted to share a couple things here. I've only got a few minutes here before I've got to be somewhere. But I wanted to share something with you guys out of this week's Torah portion, if I could do so, out of Vayetkanan, and he pleaded. Anybody out there feel like you plead every once in a while? Do you feel like you're pleading with the Father? Well, I feel that every day of my life. I feel like I am pleading with the Father to help me through my daily struggles. So I want to dive in here real quickly. And if you could turn with me, you don't have to, you can just listen along here, but let's get into Vayetkanan. That is Deuteronomy chapter 3. Just want to pull in a couple things for you real quick here. Hopefully it'll encourage you on your day. This is what I look forward to doing every single day here at Passion for Truth. I can't wait. We're not quite there, but we are getting there. So bear with me. All right. So in chapter 3, verse 22, as they're moving across, they're moving across into the promised land. It says, you must not fear them. Do not fear them. If you fear them, it says, you must not fear them, for the Lord your God himself fights for you. Do you ever feel like that the Lord God is not fighting for you? Well, I want you to hear what I have to say this afternoon, because I believe that the Father is going to encourage you that there's a reason why sometimes you don't feel like God is fighting for you. And that's because of the resistance. You see, God could have easily gone into the promised land, could have easily wiped out all of their enemies, but he chose not to do that because he wants to partner with us. All of the blood, sweat, and tears and all the difficulty of taking over Jericho or taking over the different cities is on us. We have to do our part, and then the end result is always his. Watch, it says, you must not fear them, for the Lord himself fights for you. Listen, I don't care what you're going through right now. I don't care if it's marriage problems, if you got teenager problems. I've had a couple of those myself. I know what it feels like, right? But at the end of the day, Yahweh fights for you, but there's a condition. So let's cruise on down. Again, I told you this was going to be lightning fast, and I apologize to all of our Hispanic friends out there. We're not quite there yet where we can do live streaming with translation, but we're going to get there with your help. Stay tuned. Some exciting things are happening in that event. But watch this. In verse 4 of chapter 4, it says this. It says, but you who held fast to the Lord your God are alive today, every one of you. Did you hear that? Let's back up to verse 3. It says, your eyes have seen what the Lord did at Baal Peor, for the Lord your God has destroyed from among you all the men who followed Baal Peor. But you who held fast to the Lord your God are alive today, every single one of you. Do you know what that means? That means that those who hold fast, let's just dive into the word fast real quickly in Hebrew. Okay, the word here, let me see if I can pronounce that. Okay, it is debek. All right, so debek. Debek means to cleave. It means to join. It means to stick closer than you can possibly imagine, like super glue. All right, so as hard and as powerful as super glue is, right? Me and my daughters have been talking last night. We had a fantastic Shabbat, and we were joking around about doing things to each other while we were sleeping. And one of the kids said, you know, I'm gonna take super glue and I'm gonna super glue it on Dad's lips while he's sleeping, right? So probably a lot of people would want that to happen sometimes. But at the end of the day, that super glue on skin, you can't pull it apart. It's not going to happen, right? So this is how close the Father wants us to be with Him. He wants us to be so close that we are like super glue. We're adhering to Him. It's in the process of holding fast. It is in that process when we hold fast to the Lord God. That's when we experience this scripture, which says that you are alive today. If you don't feel like you're alive, then you're not holding fast. And I think it's fascinating that the word English is fast. And in the Hebrew, it's to adhere. But in English, we say to hold fast. I think it's almost hilarious in a way, because we need to not hold slow, we need to hold fast. So in English, it actually has a double meaning. Hold fast to the Lord. God is asking you to make sure that you hold fast to Him, because life is not slow, life is fast. And when things come at you from 1,000 miles an hour, you know, your spouse says something that's snarky to you, or your employer, or something happens at your job, or you just wake up on the wrong side of the bed, I'm telling you, life happens fast. You need to hold on to Yahweh fast. And those that hold on to Him, by the way, to adhere to Him, to not depart from Him, those are the ones that God says are alive today. Every one of you, not every one of you, every one of you that are holding fast to Him. So one of the quick messages that I believe the Father has for you today is to hold fast. Matter of fact, let me just go off in the prophetic right now, because I've been sensing something in the spirit, and you need to hear this, every one of you out there. There is days that are coming, says the Lord, that you are going to be required to make a decision what you're going to hold on to for your security. Did you hear what I said? You're going to have to make a decision on what is your security blanket. For some of you, you're out there, maybe you know somebody, if it's not you, or son or daughter or someone that's out there, but you're holding on to something because your heart is broken. Your heart is broken. You're feeling a void inside of you, and maybe it's from your own sin. Maybe it's from your own mistakes that you've made. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's from someone else's mistakes, but you're feeling this incredible void in your life. I can assure you, if that is where you're coming from and you feel this void in your life, the Father says to you that the days are coming right now where you need to choose what you're going to hold on to. What is going to be your security blanket? What is going to be your super glue? Are you going to hold on to the blanket of Linus, right, from the Peanuts gang, Charlie Brown? Are you going to hold on to that blanket? What's your what do you go to for security when you feel insecurity, says the Lord? Because that which you hold on to that's not of Him will not bring you life. It will bring you death and destruction and despair. But when you hold on to Him, it will bring you life every single time. You want to be alive? Hold fast to the Lord. Let's cruise on down here. I got a couple more verses, then I got to run. Chapter 4, verse 29. But from there you will seek the Lord your God. And when you find Him, if you seek Him with all of your heart and with all of your soul, when you're in distress and all these things come upon you, when all these things come upon you, he says, in the latter days, when you turn the Lord your God and obey His voice, for the Lord your God is a merciful God, He will not forsake you nor destroy you, nor forget the covenant of your fathers, which He swore to them. For ask now concerning the days that are past, which were before you since the day that God created man on earth. Ask from one end of heaven to the other whether any great thing like this has ever happened or anything like it has ever been heard. And then he says this, did any people ever hear the voice of God speaking out to the midst of the fire as you have heard and live? Or did God ever try to go and take for Himself a nation from the midst of another nation? By trials, by signs, by wonders, by war, by a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. And he goes on all these things. It's like a Job chapter 38 and 39, right? Do you realize, you people, what kind of God that you serve? So let me prophetically take that voice, that mantle right now from this scripture and bring it into 2021 and tell you and ask you this. Have you ever seen the power of God move like you are about to today, like you have in your life? For those of you that have relationship with the Lord, have you ever seen another God love his people so much that he'd be willing to actually die himself, manifest himself in the form of a human being, cloak himself in humanity, and lay on a cross and let the very creatures that he created crucify him? What kind of God would do that but the God of Yahweh, Yahovah, the creator of the universe? Listen to me. You serve a God that's so much bigger than whatever you're going through, whatever your circumstance is, whatever your financial status is. I don't care what your mode of operating is right now. We serve a God, an Elohim, a judge, a magistrate that is so far above all magistrates, and I should know that. I've been under human magistrates. I've been under human judges, and I'm going to tell you right now, there's a bigger judge with a bigger hammer behind a bigger desk in a bigger courtroom that has the ability to come down out of heaven and change a circumstance like that. But what he's looking for us to do is to hold fast. Hold fast. Can you hold fast? Hold fast to what the Father's doing right now, because Abba is telling you right now, I believe he's about to have a breakthrough. There is a revival that's coming in this land. I feel it. It started on Shavuot of this year in my world. I don't know if it's globally, but I sense it in the Spirit. And when the Spirit allows me to sense things, you can bank on it. It's going to happen. The Spirit of God is reviving his people, and the bones of Joseph are about to raise from the dead. There is connections and generals that he's talking to right now. Kings. The Father says this, my son is the King of Kings. Where are my kings, says the Lord? Where are my kings? He's calling out to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. First to the kings. First to the judges. First to the magistrates, and when he calls them and they answer that call, there will be a move of God like you've never seen in your lifetime. The greatest revivals, the faith revivals, right? The Brownsville revivals, the revival of faith and the revival of all the revivals that have happened in the last 100 years. I used to have them all memorized, and I can't remember hardly any of them. But God is doing so, and that's because there's so much in the past. We are in need of revival right now. And I believe that the breakthrough that you're looking for in your marriage is coming. I'm telling you, but the answer is right here. It says, when you are in distress and all these things come upon you, what things? I don't care if it's COVID-19, 20, or 21. There's more things to come with that the Antichrist system is bringing. Again, I'm gonna have a lot to say about that in the future, but I can tell you one thing. The Father says, I don't care if it's that. I don't care if it's COVID-19. I don't care if it's COVID-1900. I don't care if it's the marriage problems you have. I don't care whatever distress that you have in your life. He says, when all these things come upon you in the latter days, when you turn to the Lord and obey his voice, the Lord God is merciful and he will not forsake you, destroy you, or forget the covenant of your fathers. Do you hear that? This is conditional. When, he doesn't say if. When all these things happen, when all these things come to you, when your life begins to fall apart, when things don't go your way, stop acting like a child, stop acting like an Israelite in the wilderness, and remember that the Lord God met you at Mount Sinai. Remember the miraculous, amazing display of colors and thunder and lightning and the voice of the creator of the universe talking to ants on a speck of dust in the middle of the solar system. Remember that he opened up the Red Sea. Remember that he allowed you to know who he is. Look at your spouse. If you're having marriage problems, look at your spouse and say, I remember how much I loved you when I first met you. And remember the great times. Begin to talk about it. Hold fast to that which God gave you in the beginning. He says, when you have the distress, do not forget about me, because those who call upon my name, those who adhere to me like super glue, those who don't quit, 10, 12s of the tribes of Israel quit, ladies and gentlemen, at the brink of the most amazing point in history. They were right at their destiny, right at their destiny. You know what happened? They quit. And 10, 12s of them had to live in the desert. Don't be 10, 12s, ladies and gentlemen. Vayekanan, and he pleaded, I plead with you today. The Lord God pleads with you today. Do not quit. I don't care how bad it is. I don't care how hard it is. Stop complaining and make it simple, black and white. Either I believe in the Lord God and I'm going to hold fast to him, or I'm not going to believe in the Lord God and hold fast to him. It is completely and 100% up to you. May the Lord God bless you and keep you this day. May his face shine upon you. May his countenance be lifted up over you. And listen, may he give you peace. May he give you shalom. May everything that the Creator has to offer you, may you receive it. Take your hands right now. Put them in the air right now, every one of you. Except if you're driving. If you're driving, don't do this. But if you aren't, raise your hands before the Lord God and say, Father, I receive. I receive from you, Father God, breakthrough by faith. I refuse to look at my circumstances. When my life is overwhelming, when it's falling apart, I give you my life, my trust, my faith, and all things are possible with you, my King. Say, Father, I receive the breakthrough. I reject disbelief. I reject doubt. I reject my past. Yes, like the song says, I know that you are good. I know that you are kind. So, Father God, we just come before you and we praise you and we thank you and we give you glory because you are worthy to be praised. You're bigger than our circumstances. You're bigger than our situation. You're bigger than all things, and you are in all things. Every storm that comes upon us, you are the lightning. You are the thunder. You are the rain. You're the fire. You're the air we breathe. Listen.
You are good.
You are good, Father. You are good.
I know.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
From my deepest pain, through it all, my heart will choose to sing your praise.
Know that you're good. Hallelujah.
Yeah. I know that you are good. Yeah.
I remember what it felt like to be in the hole for 84 days in a 6 by 9 foot cell with another man. And I remember crying out to the Lord God, saying, Lord, though you may crush me, I will praise your name. Amen and amen. We'll see you on the other side, ladies and gentlemen, next time. Have a great Shabbat. Shabbat Shalom.